Hello, welcome to Grimshade. So I just had to redo an episode because I wasn't happy how I played it. And now you get to see me playing at a higher level. Good for you, bad for me. I mean, I didn't play that bad, but it's just that this tutorial part was so hard to understand, that it took me a while to get it. So this tutorial basically means you'll have to use your skills. He has choked, by the way. That means you'll get more tension from a skill. He doesn't receive damage, but the tension will add up over time and he'll be unable to fight for a few rounds. And during that time, they'll just kill Kiba. They'll murder Kiba. So you just have to kill one if you can, and keep him out of trouble. That means he has to be free of the debuff. And now one is dead. Two more. Also skipped a cutscene by accident and had to reload the game, so that was not good as well. So take it how you like it, but the game is still great, even though I made some mistakes and I had to reload this video. That was about 45 minutes of video because that's how long it took me to get to that part. Okay, remove the debuff because this is almost like math in here, and I'm not really sure I like this. So one of them will apply choke and the other one will just give him a debuff to tension. Actually, it will increase his tension, but he won't be out of the fight. So let's just finish him. And just wound him, so he'll be out of the fight. And this is something I'm not sure I understand. So he needs to recover his tension, and for that he has to stay out of combat for a while. Okay, that didn't remove the debuff because he's already to the dark side. Oh well. So he should be back up with zero tension right now, and he should be start shooting at him. So it's still the same thing. Tension works in a weird way in this game. You have to learn all the things you. All the little nitpicks. So if this was a bigger battle and a character will just max tension, that will be very, very hard on you. But since this is not a bigger battle, you will have almost no problem. So that fight took me about 3 tries. Yeah, we're doing great, right? And another thing I didn't like was my attitude toward the animal people. I was very hard on them because, well, they're a bit of a stereotype character. And stereotype characters. Charlie, Alistair, my boy, where have you been? You look like you've been dragged through the sewers. I was, sort of, yeah, he was lying on the floor in the sewers. Vesper soldiers. Okay, who's your young friend then? He has a silly British accent in my head. This is Kiba. We made it in Umbridge. Well, I promised him a warm meal and shelter for the night. Only for the night? Come on, you won't kick him out. Just add for as long as it is needed. The forest? This is. Oh, look at his eyes. This is all highly irregular. By the way, I'm reading this because I want to better pronounce the English language. Anyway, it's not my first language. I want to be, I don't know, a little more fluent in English because a lot of games are in English and I'll have to speak more. So this is a good way to practice. Sorry for having to hear my voice so much. Our forces are being pushed back into the upper city. We might have to take up arms ourselves to show those invaders some manners. Some proper manners. Speaking of manners, I do apologize. It's been a tiring. Trying? Ti miss. Yeah, okay. Tiring evening. The name's Charlie Glassington. Charlinda. That sounds like a dinosaur. Charlie to my friends. You must be exhausted. It's nice to meet you, sir. Waru, waru. She's the panda lady, which annoys me because she's like, I don't know, that stereotype in animes where she has to control everything. I'll just skip a bit of our dialogue because you can read it if you want. Yeah, make his bed. The rifle stays on the wall. Okay. And now this is his rifle. And it looks different after he picks it up. It has no scope right now. Okay, I'm in a part of the forest I've never seen before. Skip the part about how you got there in the first place. I was fighting a Valkyrie, jump onto one of their flying things, managed to push her off with the gauntlet. You are finally able to call upon the powers of the Aether. This is interesting. So he has a gauntlet, but he has not been able to use it for a while. Broke my fall with it too. Yeah, he was very surprised. So he's not an experienced user with the gauntlet. That's why his powers are not so great. A huge pile of washed up bodies. You fell into the forest. Yeah, he's not keeping up with us. Right. Pile of bodies, you say? That sounds very disturbing. It was. Hey, Mr. Bear, eat your dinner. It's getting cold. All of them dressed exactly like the boy. That's where I found him, dazed and disoriented. The memory of that place still gives me goosebumps. Then we tried to get back into the city through the sewers where we were saved and then robbed by bandits. Yeah, I'm starting to get ahead. He's not that old. He doesn't look that old, or maybe he is old. I was beat up bad, first by the Umbridge, then by the bandits who stole the crystal. I still don't know what crystal they are talking about, or what kind of a crystal. Could hardly move, so I sent Kiba to find you, but he came back and healed me. With ether, Charlie. Light ether, no crystal. It's funny how he says it in his expression. With ether, Charlie, with... It reminds me of that meme from The Walking Dead where... No, okay, let's not go there. Why are you looking at me like that? I'm not crazy. Searching for the crack in your skull. Yeah, look at this. Okay. I wrote it off as fantasy or a vision, but since it's coming from you, I know it sounds unbelievable. Okay, this is where the interesting things stop, so... There's a lot of small talk in here. There you are, you filthy darkspawn. Bespierre. I always want to pronounce this name Robespierre, soldier, but it's Bespierre. Look at their cool helmet and... Are they wearing a shirt under the armor? Oh, that's fancy. Now it has a big scope on it. Ask any of you last one of you before I let you start a machine here outside now. Sure, she just kicks them out and the soldiers leave the bar for them. Highly unlikely. This is where you learn about the skill. There are no tooltips because I already did this part of the game, so. Take it as you want it, but again. Oh yeah, I shouldn't do that. First I have to put on his shield. So basically he has a skill that he does 50 damage ignoring 10 points of armor. If he does get interrupted. And they have no avoidance tokens. Which is really silly because that makes you think the battle too much instead of actually fighting the battle. First, let's mark him. Believe me, that's a lot of tutorial right there. Yes. Okay, so now it's all about planning. So, he'll be the last one in this round, and then he should start first almost. But to do that, you have to stun him. So, that's a spark, I think. He still has one avoidance token. He can act again. That's a jolt. And now it will be a stun. Either way, it was not a stun, but we cleared up his avoidance tokens. It's really hard to plan ahead and clear their avoidance tokens because that's the way the game is designed. You have to think a lot, but at the same time, you have to think in time units, and that's really hard. So let's try that again. He basically has no chance of breaking our guard, but you can't exactly kill him with this many, with this damage. Yeah, boom, headshot. What is he shooting it with? Is he shooting huge bullets, 50 caliber? Ah, these all paws haven't, still haven't lost the touch. If what you say is true, and our soldiers have been driven out of the lower districts, Trixie and mother, I must make sure. Okay. His mother and his sister. Okay, we'll go tomorrow after. This, again, doesn't make sense all. I won't be too interested in this part, because they basically say, first you sleep and then you go search for your mother and sister. That doesn't make any sense. So far, the best PR soldiers are purposely avoiding unnecessary civilian casualties. The rain seems to have dampened their fighting spirit for the night. I'm not sure of that. Yeah, Olivia. Again, her lines are basically woman power, motherhood, and of course, everyone listens to her. And I accidentally pressed space here, because it says press space to skip and go to the next cutscene, or that's what I thought. There is no sound in here, but I like the robot guy, the crazy scientist with the robot head. Yeah, this is what was taken from the boy. Looks like Dark Eater to me. Look at his left hand and on his right hand. That's amazing. Yeah, that's a cool little vision. He also got a knitted scarf, so yeah, he wants to drink some water. He says he can't pick up the book, he can't open the door. You get some items from the chest, and then let's go down. It's pretty obvious that this is still a dream sequence. Alistair? Sir Glassington? Is anyone here? I don't understand why they gave him a hat. The hat is not necessary. And he also has gloves, and he raised his sleeves up. I don't understand that. Charlie? Sir, could I trouble you for a glass of water? Water for a leaf? An Iolo, Ileor has the entire... leaf are the humans, Ileolo. Couldn't have just gone with Elor or something like that? Ileor has an entire ocean full of water. Look at all those dead bodies. No, not again. Also the Dark Eater creatures with the guts hanging out. That's disgusting. Alistair, help me, Alistair. What happened? Are you alright? It was just a dream. Yes, yes, yes. Nothing interesting. I mean, some of the dialogue is just in here to show you that they are speaking, but that's everything. So he has some clothes to wear. Still, he doesn't open the window. We already did that. Another thing I really like about it is the character customization. So let's look at this. So I don't think I can remove it. Warm and cozy scarf knitted by Waro Waro. So it adds 5 health and 10 tension, 10 maximum tension. So they actually improve his stats. And this is our wombat. I don't know, he's a badger, but I'll call him a wombat. Wombat. He has weird pants. I don't understand this design. Anyway, he's very, very frail. I mean, even Kiba has more health than him. But he can go for a lot of tension, and his initiative is the biggest of the group. And they level up quite differently. And they also have better resources, so in order to mark, if he marks a target, I think that will raise his... raise his level or something like that. I'm not sure of it, because hey, Okay, that's enough explanation. This game really suffers from too much explanation sometimes. We're in a war zone. Stop talking to random animals. Yeah. I'll just click on everything if you want to read that. Also, let's talk to Boris. I'll call him Boris because he's a bear. And he has actually a lot more dialogue, Dorian. Who are you? He's just a wealthy Eliolor, burning my wealth and time in hopes of meeting an art lover. Eh, something about art, yes, spicy wind tavern. And now he's speaking that he's stranded here and he can't go back to his home where he has a lot of pieces of art. Keep all between. Come on, guys. He's a small child that has been traumatized and hurt in battle, shot even, and you're just taking him with you. You haven't held that rifle for a decade, Charlie. Why now? We had plenty of trouble in the city before. What's changed? I can feel it in my bones. Waru. Silly name. Something is amiss, and I can't sit this on out. My hunter's sense, they shouldn't have put the S there, is telling me it's important. My hunter's sense. My hunting senses, maybe. I don't know, they're still animals, so. Hunter's nonsense, yeah, that's the word I'm looking for. I can't let the boys go alone, can I? But what about the rest of the younger animal people? Boris seems strong, and the other people seem strong too. I think Dorian should have some pistol up his sleeve because he's a noble or something. Come back in one piece. I will. The only thing you know how to take a peek at is the scope of that rifle of yours. Not really enjoying the dialogue between the two of them. The panda lady is not my style. Are you mounting an excursion into the lower districts? Esteemed proprietor. Owner. Fighting seems to have escalated since dawn and the champions of Bran are nowhere to be seen. It's... what? It says so right here on the front page. Where are they? And what of the people? Most civilians have been evacuated to the upper city and have found shelter in the flood of the Lambent Mothers. Yeah, those are the nuns that were kind of creepy in the beginning. Okay, some citizens are barricaded. Okay, then let's hurry. We wasted so much time. Also, here you are introduced to the crafting part of the game. Ah, this was such a long tutorial. So again, I didn't know what to expect, so I had to make some adjustments. So 4 water, 5 guar, and 2 honey. Okay, I understand. And 2 honey, so that's about it. You can also buy medicines here. And I'll actually buy one. Actually, 2, to be sure. The dialogue is kind of not interesting, so I'll just tell you the short story. It's a normal life in here. Our numbers are getting larger, the Iliolor. Anyway, I'm not really interested in their story. At least not for now. If there's something interesting, I'll let you know. And you can craft the bottles here. He's a big boozer. I don't know how to tell you this, but if he drinks, then he doesn't have to focus. Okay, so these are all his items. But unfortunately, this is a one-use item only, so I don't understand the purpose of it. It's a one use, and that means you just use it and it goes away. And the tutorial site says Yeah, that's him. Basically, the tutorial wants you to do it in the first combat you meet. Okay, let's go and fight. And now we'll meet our old friends, our esteemed colleagues, the sewer robbers, the sewer bandits. That's a good name for them. And yes, still in a state of war, people are still fighting other people because, oh, I hate this so much. I mean, this has been done in so many movies, animes, and then any other type of, I don't know, any other type of storytelling. Humans fighting humans when they should be not fighting humans because drama. And then we'll actually see the city. Yeah, at least a part of the city. I don't know how big it will be. Okay, so basically the tips are very good here. You use fast skill to remove avoidance tokens. Hello, sewer bandits. Darcy. Hey, Badger. Wind sends regards. Asked to pass along that you're serving rotten guara, the spicy wind. Even the Tayon smells of mold in your filthy tavern. They seem so happy when they tell him things like that. He's a badger. He could kill you with his hands. Or even one toe of his leg. Of his. Yeah, that's a grave insult. Associating an Ilior with an animal that they resemble by name is considered to be a grave insult, as you should be aware. Solid walloping, yeah. Lay off, Badger. We're in Bran, not some filthy Ilior backwater. Us in the big city are used to being able to say whatever we want to whoever. Whomever. Whatever, as I was. Yeah. It's a lot of back talk. Charlie, don't start with that. So we basically have to fight. Again, the dialogue here is they have a boss and they don't question their orders. Now, they're basically telling you can arrange your troops differently. And we will do that. But that's about all I want to move for now. Because they are so squishy, these two. Oh, very, very squishy. Okay, we avoided that. Now, what's that? Well, that's a skill that removes his. It's a debuff. It lasts for 2 turns. So they basically tell you if you want to get rid of that debuff, use fast skills like shooting someone, or just use his ability to get rid of the debuff. So we'll just do that because that debuff means he has no avoidance tokens and his armor is lowered. Remember, he's using the Light Eater, so that means he can remove a debuff. So he has a spark, he's starting to get very stressed. No, I'm not aiming at Corvin or at anyone else. Relax game, I know how to do it. Korovin. Now, if I remember correctly, if I aim at him, he'll just come and attack me. So, to be sure that one happened, let's just use his book again. I'm pretty sure that's how he levels up, but I can't be too sure, so I'll just try it anyway. Don't worry, until we get him stunned, we can basically do nothing. So yeah, use a fast attack to remove his avoidance token. By the way, with his skill he can attack anyone on the map. Unavoidable. Yeah, you could always try to kill him first. And that's what I recommend if you don't want to use your booze, your drink. And let's actually use his last weakness on this guy. Come on. Oh, he doesn't have any battle resources. By the way, you can't attack the guys in behind him, so that's a little strange. Okay, let's use that avoidance token and now let's stun him. Actually, this won't be a stun, this will be a spark. So next turn we will stun him. Again, nothing happens. He'll still take some hit points of us. So if you do it like this, he'll just continue to attack him and he'll also get stunned. But he still does a lot of damage, this guy. But now he is the one stunned. And to be honest, I need his avoidance tokens to not receive damage from this guy. Yeah, this is a lot of things you have to plan and think about. Now, he will be stunned next turn, so I better not do it. Yeah, this is... Again, it's a consumable item. You only get one shot with it. After that, you have to craft it again. And I'm not sure I will keep this party composition. Maybe I'll change it. Okay, let's do more damage to him. 13 damage. He's one attack away from being dead. That did no damage. He should be waking up. I'm not sure he will have... Yeah, he does have his avoidance tokens. So let's just kill him now. I'm sure the developers didn't want me to do it like this. They wanted me to use this one and use it on Darcy. That would have made the fight a lot faster, but I don't know. I like to challenge myself sometimes. And again, I don't like to waste items. Maybe I'll have just 9 drinks at the end of the game like that. Okay, now all of them have been researched by the Wombat. I guess this is the only one I could choose. So he should attack him and he should get stunned right now. I don't know why he chooses to... Actually, I know, he chooses to attack him because he wants to remove his avoidance tokens and his armor. Minus 10 armor, look at that. Oh, you're not stunned? Too bad, now I have to kill you with the pistol. Again, if he doesn't... Goodbye, Darcy. Don't worry, he'll be back. Okay, this fight is not so hard because you can just go back into the haven and heal up. Now we can use this skill on him. Take aim. There are plenty of lights in here. And I don't know, maybe many people complain that you can't level up your heroes in the proper way of the world, in the proper RPG way. So we just have to do the little side quests and mechanics to do it. And yeah, some other people say you should just be able to go up there and just kill him. But that's not possible, as you can see. So you'll just have to attack him for 4 damage all this time. I wish you could go up and then up again and then kill him, but... that's not how the game is designed. Come on, Wombat, finish him. We'll kill him until he... Okay. This is another problem that I don't like about the Wombat. By the time he actually gets a turn, it will be kind of late anyway. Okay, you win, enough already. But what's happening here, you may ask? Well, you'll see in a bit. Boss doesn't tell us nothing about the big plans. You have to go directly to the source if you want to know more. Would you like to know more? Yes. Better watch out, Badger. Wins will get you one of those days. Bye. They stole my stuff again. That's amazing. They stole his stuff again. What in the world did they want this time? Charlie, we have to catch up with them. Teach them a lesson so they won't soon forget. Calm yourself, boy. You'll get your chance sooner or later. We have more pressing matters at hand. Yeah, they are a part of the city, those guys. So this is not the last time we see them. Okay, let's go for the lower brand then. And this has kind of a free range mechanic, I don't know how to call it. You can explore the city quite a bit. But first, I recommend you just go back. We have 5 healing items. Did I buy all those healing items? I don't remember. Or did we get 2? As you can see, he's back. Five medical supplies were maxed out. And to be honest, I don't want to craft anything else, and I'm not sure we can craft anything else except that potion. His little drinking bottle. And yeah, that increased his level. You see, we applied the notebook on each of those things, on each of our opponents. So he levels up by feeding crystals into his gauntlet. He levels up by reading more about his opponents. Don't mess with Badger. Charlie's notebook. Charlie's compendium. Now, as you can see, we have the map available to us as well. Come on, boy. Go outside. So until now, I thought that we had no map, or the map was very strange, so... Yeah, this is the reason. Reunion Square, and I have a feeling this is the Spiceman Tavern. You'll just go down, explore the whole city, and then go up again, and then finish the best PR army. We did a quest. So this is where I land the level, and oh man, it was so bad the last time I played. I mean, the last save was about 45 minutes when I saw it. See you next time. Bye.